see.
They just called me down.
Oh, they're going in there.
Hello.
We're amongst friends. Mm-hmm. I'm not talking to you. And I know you're kind of familiar with this whole Navarro thing through Randy. Alright? Help me out with this. Because we do care about Randy. Alright? Been trying to get him help. Been trying to talk to him. Trying to get everything. Bridget's been my sounding board.
We got to do something else for him to help him. You don't think there's nothing else we can do? You know, maybe even trying to refer him something. Some. We got to be able to help him. And there's a way, there's got to be a way for us to be able to help him. And and you guys talk to him more than I do. But, you know, that's why he's asking me right now. Because I just think that, I think he needs help.
We've been trying to get him help. I got a psychologist. Hell, I'll pay for the shit, you know?
Yeah, but that's true, dude. That's true brotherhood right now.
Right. Dave, I've done this. I think I gave you the name and number, didn't I? But this is the thing. We got to be tread carefully because Randy, he can shut down. And then where are we at? Then we have no access to him. Bridget, poor Bridget here, we talk every day because I'm like, fuck, I can't even imagine what it's like to be with her. Because she deals with a whole lot more stuff. And I consider us like
that. I heard the conversation.
Yeah. And I was trying to tell him with this whole transfer thing. I don't know if you know, but someone must be talking with the chief because he came up with the idea of moving Dave.
Okay.
Well, I mean.
Oh, yeah, I know that.
So I'm trying to let Dave know, look, we got to stick together, all right? I know you're upset. It bothers me. Hell, I didn't get no sleep last night either. And I swore on my mother. On my mother who's still alive. May God take her right now if I'm lying. But I've done nothing but want to make sure that you're taken care of. I've never lied to you, never tried to steer you wrong. And yeah, it might seem like we talk bad about Randy. That's us venting. That's us being pissed.
I understand that part.
You know? But at the same time, he is who he is, and we gotta take him for who he is.
I wanna take you a little bit farther back. Did all your paperwork for you.
Right. You think I don't think about that daily?
I just want you to remember. I didn't have to do that. But that's when our bond really began. You know, I mean, we were really close.
Well, I thought we were close before that.
Well, no, we were close, but I mean, but we stepped into a whole new level of our relationship after that. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay?
Well, we came up with a pact.
That's right, we came up with a pact. And then the three of us talk about, you know, freaking speaking to, you know, to Marvin the other day. He goes, man, I remember when you took over that freaking chief of police position in Fort Jackson. Motherfuckers out on the street. People are talking shit, man. In Richland County, that motherfucker ain't staying there. And Reuben is coming right back. Them three motherfuckers end up in the city, they're going to be together. There's no way they're going to be apart. I said, I don't give a fuck how much money Dave's making on Fort Jackson. He's going after Randy. Dude, here we are, and then you guys make me believe that we're this freaking, what do we call ourselves, a fucking a dream team, and brother, we're not acting like it right now. We got to fucking
but
come down together.
Whose fault is
that? I know, but that's what I'm saying, we need to get them help, because I'm telling you right now, man, I looked at all this shit right now, that people will do anything, Ruben, and that's what I'm saying. I know. You my boss, man, and I love you, and I'm
your friend first.
And I know you're my friend, but, you know, that man sat right there in my fucking car the same damn way he got in your fucking car and told me, watch that motherfucker, him and Chris Cowan, fuck me, okay? Ooh. I'm telling you, you have opened the door, and I tell you, I brought that motherfucker here. You didn't bring him. You proved everything. I begged you. I sucked your dick to get him in here, okay? And now he's treating me like that. Brother, that's a dangerous motherfucker.
Of course it is, but that's why you can't play into his game, Dave.
Oh, gee, but you have told me we're not tolerating that shit anymore.
Right.
I know he's a master at what the fuck he does. I was just reading all his shit. He's a master.
He just did a damn good job with
that. Yeah, I know, and I'm not taking that away from him, but just because he does a good job, he's still, I'm going to tell you, and I told you this before, Scott Thor does not, and he doesn't like authority. He does not want to answer to nobody.
But what did I tell you about that? I told you about Edison County. And I told you, you got to know how to play Scott. Scott is an asshole. Scott is self-serving only. Oh, I thought November. The only thing that I do with Scott, I had to stroke his ego. Hey, man, you're doing a great job.
And
keep it up.
I do that every fucking day.
But you got to understand. Because you are, your style of leadership with accountability and stuff, he's not going to respond well to that. Now, you shouldn't have to bend to that. But if you want it to work, at least for now, you got to compromise. I expect them to talk shit about us. It's our job. Remember I told you we had this conversation, military. It's almost natural if they don't talk shit about command, something's wrong, you know?
Yeah, well, you're really not doing your job.
Right. We always say, man, the first time, fucking don't
that's
know
what you're right,
doing. Man, fuck the first time.
Well,
about to come. Yeah.
Right.
Same situation here, okay? But with this whole, we got a couple things going on. Number one, you're taking this thing too personal. If you don't want to move, I'm fine with that. The chief is the one who told me, what did I do to you? As soon as I got the phone, I said, Dave, I was very direct. Brother, we're going to have to transfer you. Remember
right,
I said that?
Work. And again,
did I do that, though? Because, man, I don't want to candy coat it or look like that I'm bullshitting you.
Well, but at that point right there, again, standing up for what is right. And I was telling you, and I know you don't have to agree with me on that. The same way, respectfully, sir. Mm-hmm. You know, man, Randy.
But I don't think it's the
Randy,
wrong idea at the same time,
it's
man.
Not the wrong idea, but it's the way it's being handled. Listen, let's not do Dave like that. Let's give him a week. Let me put out something from the academy, or maybe when you come back, you know, send out an email. Look, we'll consider that same email you send out. It would look so much smoother, or Randy Martin on the meeting. Hey, we're going to be doing some moving.
Now, to me, I feel like that's a coward way to do it. If it's coming from me, I should be man enough to tell you myself.
Yeah, but you're not here. He's taking your place.
Right, but that's the same thing Randy Scott's doing right now. He's got me moving you
okay,
while
so
he's
you
not here.
So we call it cowardly, but I mean...
I'm not saying cowardly, but in my eyes, I think it should be...
Well, let me ask you this, then why, I mean, really to justify moving a division as big, the commander, the leader of the freaking division, you know, basically overnight. I know you say now it's going to take a week and all that stuff, but man...
Yeah, it can't happen overnight.
No,
but once you want to know now, then later...
The logistics, that's right, the logistics... In this thing, man.
Right. Dave, you got to stop thinking that the shit was going to happen yesterday, effective immediately type deal. No, it'd have to be a transition. All right? And brother, I bent over backwards even to make it to where we asked for people's opinions, so it wouldn't be
but you
appearance.
Ain't
going
to do that until I ask you to do that, man. Then you,
well, that night, didn't I own up to that? I said, Dave, I didn't realize it was going to affect you like this.
And then I sent an email volunteering to fucking leave. And when I talked to him yesterday, he said, "Oh, well, how you feeling? I'm doing. Oh, great, shit, y'all moving. Oh, chief." When he told me, he said, "You all right? You all right with the move?" I said, "Yeah, I'll go wherever you want me to go. That's not what I really want to do." But and then
well,
the same shit that you did about me taking over this shit when he told you, "No, I ain't moving Dave unless he wants to go to community service." And then you, God damn it, Dave, that's the heart of the fucking department. You
right.
Came here for the drinking.
So why the fuck would I want you to move from here?
No, I know that part.
But you're holding me responsible.
No, you guys...
You done threw me under the bus with the chief and everything.
No, I didn't. It's the way this was handled. It's the way it was handled, man. If we
so what kind of damage control do I need to do with Randy?
No, I'm saying, huh?
What kind of damage control do I need?
Ain't no damage control. I mean, right? I mean, what is the damage control?
I don't know. I figured you wanted to probably discredit me and say that
no,
Ruger's just trying to get rid of me.
The only thing I said was, listen, this
he's
shit...
He's talking shit about you.
No. The only thing I said was, I said, man, I need to know who has saying what. Because you saying I'm not...
I'll tell you shut up.
I
have evidence of this.
He said you told him you want to move me. He's and now you're telling me no, it's him moving me. Well, I understand. Mm-hmm. I'm really saying it's him, but I mean, I said,
he never said it to me though.
Okay.
Yeah.
So why are you lying?
But
to,
you
I said,
knew
why,
about it.
I said, what are you lying to me? I'm your friend. I'm your brother.
We're not.
I'm the A team. I'm part of the fucking dream team.
Help me here.
You know, just tell me the truth.
Smile or
you.
Something. Dude.
I'm not sure how I'm. All right,
let me be selfish on this. You know, all of my plans that I've been doing to try to get promoted, Randy.
I understand all that.
For him, when he gets promoted, then we all move up. This is just, when he mentioned that he needed to move, then I said, you know what? Okay, we've been talking about it for a few months anyways. And then, in my mind, what I'm thinking is Dave can go there. It's laid back. We can start really making the shit happen. Behind the scenes shit that we really want to happen, make it happen. Here, your time is too monopolized. Your fucking phone right now, I can't even leave a message.
No, it's clean.
Right, as of yesterday.
That's right.
But you know, I don't have access to you like I need you to. And if you're going to be my number two, or my number one, then fuck. I need you to be included.
No, I understand that, man. We're gonna beat this dead horse until, you know, I don't know.
Tell me what you want. You want to hear.
No, I just said.
It fucks my plans up, but okay.
I don't care. I don't care about whether I stay here. I'm okay with going to another region. No. Again, it was the way this whole thing was handled.
Okay.
If it now was put out to the commanders, the way we, you know, you talked about strategy, this morning. And that strategy respectfully sucked. You don't do that to somebody, man.
Dave,
I mean,
only because
you're not used to that, man.
I understand that. That's the part that sucks. The part that sucks is that
that's a release, and where I come from is a relief for calls. And you open up for the entire family. Why did they move that motherfucker? Something's up. And
then even if I do it your way, people are still gonna say that shit.
I disagree with that because as much as I don't like that motherfucker, that motherfucker did it the professional way.
He's never done it exactly like that.
No, chief.
Name one person he moved that wasn't immediately.
Most of the moves that he made were done during Christmas holidays, promotions, or when somebody got in trouble and they were gone.
All right, you remember those Christmas holidays? Everyone's, oh fuck, it was good if you got promoted. Like Randy Scott, everyone, oh major. All right, Captain.
All right.
What about the person who didn't get promoted? Who thought they would?
Yeah, but that happened in our Christmas party. People got promoted, some people didn't get promoted. Right. You can't make everybody happy.
Exactly. Right. That's what I'm saying. But he did it with no notice. No one knew nothing about where they were going to go, if they got transferred, if they got moved. Hell, when Zane Padgett got moved to IA, or what's his name, the asshole in IA got moved to community services, we're like, what the fuck? I'm very conscious of that because I don't want that. I didn't even announce it to nobody, dude.
Hey, Mr. Santiago, this is Coach Knopf at Glen Forest School.
And then the other thing is, you know, I to sell out to the department that, no, Dave is going out there, and that's why I wrote my email back to you like that, to enhance my, you know, my opportunities with career enhancement, you know, with the department.
Let's play it this way, because you're right. All right, let's quarterback this. You moved out to West Region. In a few months, Chief Randy Scott gets promoted. Hopefully, I'd like to be chief, and then you move up. What are people going to say then? Oh, those slick motherfuckers, they knew the whole time.
They're going to say, that motherfucker didn't get no road experience.
Right.
He went to West Region. Why didn't they put him in South Region or freaking Metro?
Right, but there's no solid solution to make everyone happy on this, you know? But at least you went to West Region, because we don't have a timetable on this, you know?
You know, the other day, and I don't know, this could be a completely speculation on my part. You know, I'm very good at that. I guess speculating. But I walk upstairs, man, and I saw Jimmy Hall and freaking Stover sitting right next to you in your office. And I'm thinking, this cannot be good. Okay? I'm serious.
Okay.
No, the next day, I found out about this shit. You think about that for a little
bit. All right. I can see how that looks that way.
Okay, you see what I'm saying?
But I swear on my living mother, with your name never came up. Do you know what we're talking about? Do you know where I just came from? Do you know where I just came from? I did a press release.
Yeah, I saw it on the
Scott's program. That's why he's up there. But you saw Jennifer there. Jimmy came up there, honestly, only because of the whole Rowson situation. Rowson and Kelly Yates. That was the only thing. He goes,
right,
damn, dude, you didn't even tell me that Rowson moved and what the fuck.
And I'm not saying that. I just told you. I'm not speculating. But just think about if you were in my shoes, how would I look the next day?
I don't think you would come and talk to me, Dad.
I tried to.
Brother, I would drop anything and talk with you. You know that.
You've been so damn busy, baby, man.
No, that's true.
But listen, I don't want to. I'm serious. I'm praying, man. And I'll tell you, honestly, I already talked to my wife, brother. I really think that I'm going to.
I think it's the biggest mistake you made, Dad. How is that going to look to your reputation?
What do you mean?
Where can you go from here that's going to be better?
It doesn't matter. I got 2 years, brother. I mean, I got 2 years. I'm not looking for anything like that. You know what my brother-in-law, honestly, my brother-in-law in Florida told me? Motherfucker, you retire once. Retire again in 2 years and you're done. I mean, why are you killing yourself with you know, stuff like that?
Yeah, but
you know,
why not retire here?
He stayed, you know what he told me? I stayed a deputy sheriff the whole fucking time. I'm making over $60,000 and I don't have to deal with all that bullshit you're dealing with. I said, you know what? You're fucking right, but I guess I'm trying to be ambitious. Well, trying to be ambitious and fed for my family.
I'll make this very clear in front of a witness. I love you like my brother. I've never changed from that. If you really look deep in your heart, you know I've never done nothing malicious and I've never told you a lie. Okay? I've stayed the course and I've kept my oath and our pact.
You're not, I can't do nothing with that, babe.
You're
accusing, but you make allegations that I have a morale issue in my unit over one man, and then you don't give me anybody. I stole it.
I have not talked to that motherfucker. Man. God damn. See, how insulting it is to me.
That shit's out there, man.
Call that motherfucker right now.
Let me ask you something. Do you believe what I'm telling you, that he jumped in my car the same way he got in your car and told me those things?
I believe that. If you said it, I believe it.
I'm telling you, Ruben. Right. He did that.
But what am I...
That should have some fucking value and some weight.
But what would it do right now for me to fucking call him on the carpet about that? Do I really give a shit about that?
That's not what we want to do.
Do lions care what sheep think?
Right, right. You're absolutely right. And I don't want to do that. Yeah. I don't want to do that. But at the same time, man, I want to make sure that I don't become a victim of the circumstances on the process of us trying to move up and whether or not the chief gets promoted and all that stuff. And I know you're trying to make some transitions to make sure that you look good, and I would do the same thing. This is not being critical. This is being professional.
I haven't done nothing without the chief's approval.
No, I know that. I know that. I'm not saying that. I'm saying if I was in your position, I would try to shine as much as I can while I'm the interim chief. I would. And if you would be stupid not to. Excuse me.
Yeah, but what? I've never said nothing without saying Chief Randy Scott.
Right.
Today at my press conference.
But who's saying that? I'm not even saying that. I'm saying that because I said I don't want to become a victim of the circumstances. That, you know what? Fuck that. Send his ass to West Region. I ain't got time for that right now. I got things to do for myself. Because I'm the interim chief and I need to get this done. I'm leaving Friday. That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying nothing about what you said about the chief or whether you say his
name. I
don't care about that shit.
I personally, if I knew up front that this was a plan to move you, you and I would have went to lunch. I'd have talked about it, and I would have told you, Dave, this is what's being considered. I would have done that. You know I would have done that, okay? But because things are happening so quickly, now, the chief makes decisions off whatever information he gets. I'm not privy to anyone he talks to. Hell, for all I know, Stover could have talked to him. Jennifer Jordan could have talked to him. Any of those people that fall under you, I've never entertained it.
You're absolutely right. I haven't ruled that out.
So, I'm the target of your frustration on this when I'm the victim.
I'm not trying to be the victim because this is the thing.
You're a grown man, I'm a grown man. Whatever decision you make, I can't make you change them. I love you and I don't want nothing bad to happen to you. And I think when you make decisions under emotional situations, I think people tend to make bad ones. And for you to even contemplate leaving is ridiculous, Dave. It's ridiculous. For selfish reasons, you're part of the team that I need. For your personal reasons, from an outside looking in, damn, dude, that's going to make you look bad. Unless you go back to Richland County, CPD is the best thing going on. Where are you going to go? Not that you don't have options, you know what I mean? And it depends on your lifestyle, what you want. But the Dave Navarro I know, we don't max the minimum. We excel at every step we take, and we're going to be the best of the best. And that ain't no pep speech, but it's the philosophy that you want to be a big fish in a small pond, or a big fish in a big pond.
And I couldn't agree with you more on that, Ruben. But the ultimate pact that we made is not working.
I've held my bargain, brother.
Huh? It's not working.
Where have I violated the pact? And
I asked myself, haven't you asked yourself? You've had to been laying in your bed, looking at that ceiling, saying, "Where the fuck are we going? What's going on?"
Yeah, every day.
Why are we doing this,
Bridget? Every day.
You know,
Bridget has been my confidant only because I don't have a direct line to the chief, and I'm not using you, by the way. I'm just saying. But you know what? Bridget's a victim in this. Bridget cares about the chief just like you and I do. We want to see him do good. She's done everything from her standpoint to try to get him to do the right things, you know? But you know, the same way he treats her, and dude, it's the same way we get treated, all right? And me and Bridget, we come up with strategies all the time. Yeah, there's things I haven't told you, Dave, but only because, you know what? The less people that, right, the less people that knew, it was the better, all right? But the one thing that we have in common, right, us three, is that we care and we love about it. We love the chief. I don't want to see nothing bad happen to that motherfucker. I don't. Think about this, and he says this clearly all the time. Ruben, you're one of a few people who can really fuck me if you want to. Why wouldn't I have put an application in if I wanted to fuck him? Or why wouldn't I have done everything to discredit him this whole last couple weeks or until the next week? Hell, I had the city manager in my office up there, and every other word was Chief Randy Scott. His philosophy is what we've done. Community service, community policing.
Nobody's questioning that.
I know, but shouldn't that prove to him that I love him? And shouldn't that prove that I got that we have his best interests? I mean, the sacrifices you made with pay, the things that we've talked about. Brother, I put my name out there on a ledge, and I'm not doing it for your thanks, because I do it for the right thing, with pay. Bridget's helped me with the pay thing, you know? Right, Bridget? I mean, yours is the one on the very top of the list, you know? I've done nothing but try to uphold what I said I was going to do.
And
I'm not going to violate that, no matter how you feel about it.
No, man, I just, I'm telling you, I think that for the most part is and I've already explained myself over and over and over. I'm not disagreeing with, you know, the majority of the stuff you're saying. But at the same time, I don't think you're hearing me out. You and we may agree to disagree on this, but man, the way this shit was handled was sloppy.
I can agree with you on that.
If we want to be, look what you just said about the Columbia Police Department. You said, well, you can go to Richland County. You can go. This is we're it. We're not going to be it like this, man. We're not going to be it if we continue to act like we. And little things like, and I'll tell you this, little things. Like that fucking email that I sent out on professional courtesy, we need that stuff. And if I'm going to be punished for something, I'm not saying you are, okay, but we're going to let a little whiny, crying kid come in here and say, oh, he's picking on me because I came to see you. It simply says, if the chiefs call you up there, man, they're going upstairs like this fucking candy store. And Ron and I are keeping no account. We have no account. Every time I go upstairs, fucking community services up there. We have no accountability.
You just condemned me thinking that I entertain their shit.
No.
Right now, if you went upstairs and talked to Weiser, and I showed him your memo, and I said, man, this is exactly what we need to put out. I said, we need to package it different because you said some shit that I wouldn't have said. And it's dangerous to put that stuff on paper because now they can use it to try to push their own agendas, you know, maybe use it as ammunition. Oh, look what he said, this and this and that. That's what people do, Dave, when they want to be malicious. They try to get you to react to things, you know?
Yeah, but what was malicious in that memo?
No, I'm not saying. Like, all right, say I was one of your subordinates, and I got this memo. Oh, man, look at the fucking captain don't want me to go up there talking so-and-so. Oh, what happened to open door park? They might not understand the spirit of your memo. But they will try to do is manipulate
it. But even open door policy and say, hey, I'm heading to see the chief.
Brother, I'm agreeing with you 100%. I just told you I liked your memo. I even told it to what's his name? Weiser. And I Faith even read it last night. I said, hey, help me out. Because a lot of times from an outsider's perspective, I say, hey, tell me what you think about this. I want to put this out. But she was like, oh, it's fantastic. This is exactly what you're going to be doing. Dave, it's the exact same thing you and I have been preaching. All right. So,
you guys brought me here and paid me here to be able to right. do stuff like that. And
if you were fucking up something, I would tell you, man. Or if someone came to me, you think I would entertain them for a second? I'm like, hold the fuck up. You know me and Dave are friends. I've had to tell that to Mac Marsh and Jimmy. I was like, y'all need to make sure you tread carefully, because that man is my friend. All right. If he's fucking up, then I'll address that. But if he's not, then move on. And that's why their tone has always been very careful. But they'll say good things now. And I'm not saying they're trying to kiss your ass or kiss my ass. But they always say, you know what? We might not like the way Duvall does things, but at the end of the day, that's the hardest working motherfucker here. You know?
I'm appreciate that. And I'm a little funny.
And have you not heard the same thing?
And stuff like that, you know?
There's a lot of people that don't like you, Dave, and I think you know that.
Yeah, all right? I know that, but you're not going to please everybody.
I know. But remember when we were at that one captain's meeting? And I said, Dave, don't let these motherfuckers bait you, you know? Because I know you're very passionate. I know you got a lot of pride when it comes to your name and what you do. And any attack on that usually results in you firing back something. Remember, I even said, all right, look.
No.
I said, Dave, look.
I'm not arguing with you. I'm not
100%. I know. And I know that about you. That's why.
Because I'm very meticulous on the way I do things. And I take very much pride in what I do. Remember, that's all right.
Remember with those two guys that wrote the Signal 30 hours and shit, and you were pissed off?
And I
even said,
I extinguish that shit.
I said, Dave, do me a favor. When you address it, don't go head on with them.
Sure,
don't do this. And just get them to say their side, and then you take care of it. What does he do? Hey, motherfucker, what the fuck's up with this shit? And by the way, you ain't on the damn detail no more.
You're right.
But Dave, right.
Well, so you know where that comes from.
I think
know
yeah.
You know, and
I resist it all the time.
And it's the structure that I was brought up in the military is the only thing I know.
And it's Latino culture, brother.
And it's our our heritage. And you know, and I tell you, and I tell Randy, that structure may be fine and dandy. That was back in the Army. And if that's not what's working in here, you as my boss. Man, I expect you, I invite you, I challenge you to say, hey, motherfucker, no, not here. Randy did that shit to me in Richland County. I said, man, don't try to pull that first sergeant bullshit in here. That shit ain't gonna work here, motherfucker. This is paramilitary, but this ain't the fucking Army.
Yeah.
He told me that. Woo! Yeah. I backed up for about 2 years. I never did anything like that. He said, you're absolutely right. Sometimes it takes that. It's the same thing with our fucking wiser. Yeah. And I told you this before. Nobody has sat down and told that man,
this
ain't the fucking FBI. He never had the humble experience to being a deputy sheriff, a master deputy, a corporal, a sergeant, a lieutenant, like me and you.
Right.
Okay? And if somebody sits him down, man, you might have been, was he the ASAC? What was he?
The SAC.
He was a SAC. Okay? Well, he's coming from the SAC position into an assistant chief of police. That's two fucking top-heavy fucking positions. And I know, Chief, I'm boring you with this.
No, I got it.
But what I'm telling you right now, you know this stuff. What I'm telling you right now, if somebody will sat him down and said,
right.
This is a police department. We don't run like the federal agency. This is the things you do. This is how you, you might have been the sack there.
And trust me, that's like Randy Scott. So many times we told Randy, look, just tell him, brother. Just tell him. Hell, he'll quit if you ask him to quit. He will. But,
yeah,
Randy's got a big heart. He doesn't want to fucking give people bad news. You know that about him. But I think the issue on this is you feel like someone's come to me, told me some shit, and now I need to make a change.
You need to make a change.
No, I mean, I think the whole you reacting the way you are on this is you feel like, correct me if I'm wrong, I think you feel like somebody has come to me with information, like Scott Stover, or whoever.
I'll be honest with you, man. I'm not going to sit here and sugarcoat and lie to you. I don't trust them. And I'm asking you guys, I've asked you even 3-4 weeks ago, I said, listen, there's some issues in there between personal.
And we can
fix that. He has taken
this
shit personal. I even told you, man, I know you, the drug suppression team was not supposed to be in community service. How many times y'all did that over there? Back and forth. I know crime prevention is supposed to be
in
community
service. This reminds me a little bit of that, by the way.
Right? Well, how many crime prevention... Whatever work he does, it doesn't matter, he's going to do it. He can, for whatever reason, he cannot adjust my leadership style. And man, it's very difficult, unless I'm doing something wrong and you and Randy tell me to change that shit, I'm not going to stop it. I'm not going to stop anything unless...
I've never asked you to.
Right, and that's what I'm saying. I'm not going to cater to his little mommy, don't...
Brother, if you write his ass up now, you don't think I'm going to endorse him?
Right.
Or if you decide to terminate him,
I'm
going to endorse him?
You laugh about this shit, but I'm telling you, that motherfucker's not mentally stable. I'm telling you right now, I saw him yesterday parking in. I went, hey, Scotty, how you doing? Shake your hand. How you doing?
Yeah, but you know what?
Mad at me, dude.
That's a character flaw.
Great job, dude. But, you're doing a great job with that, SRP
right.
program.
But is he violating any policy? It's a character flaw. We can't expect everyone to be our friends. But it's a character flaw on the extreme.
Right.
But I can't fault him, and I'm not going to keep him on because of this, but when he does his job, he does his job.
He's fucking top of the line. Nobody can fucking touch him when it comes to that.
But see, I think you feel like our trust got violated, like someone came to me and that this was a vendetta against you. It's not that at all, Dave. It wasn't never that. Now, if Chief Scott got somebody whispering in his ear, I can't speak on that. But all I did was when he called me and said, man, we're going to have to make a change. And I didn't argue with him. You're right. I probably should have, okay? But I didn't. Only because of my train of thought was, all right, that kind of fits in what I needed anyways. I need him to be able to flow out of there so that when time comes, that shit goes without a hitch.
Respectfully, you know what I would have done? You told me we were talking to Dave and Ruben. I would have said, Chief, Dream Team, is that the way we want to treat David?
It's still the Dream Team.
Everything that we have asked that motherfucker, he has done.
Right.
And then some. Is that the way we want to go with it?
Right.
I mean, we can do, we still do it, Chief, but I think we need to use a different strategy.
Well, we can't do it now. The shit got too fucking big. Because you know what? After I talked to you last night and I took my marching orders from the Chief, hell, at 8 o'clock last night, I talked to Jimmy Allen. I said, Jimmy Allen, and I kept it simple. I said, the Chief's going to make a change, and we're looking at flipping both of y'all. And boy, next thing you know, that motherfucker, I guess that shit is getting out. Because I had a couple people this morning that was like, hey, I hear some changes going. I said, nope. I said, I called Jimmy at 7:30 this morning. I said, that shit's been canceled. Fucking make sure you anyone you told, you make sure they know that crystal clear. All right? So, I just kind of made it a big emotion there, to be honest. You know? And honestly, I had no idea you was going to take it like this. I mean, to me, this was a position where we catapulted our agenda. And my thoughts was when this came across, we'll still continue to do that at West Region.
And Chief, I had no idea you guys were going to handle it like this.
Handle like what? Brother, I tried to tell you as soon as I knew.
You agree with me that this was not handled right.
Right. It could have been handled better. I'm still trying to think about how that could have been done because do we want to do it happen fast or happen slow?
No, I would just, I just explained it to you. We have already joked around about us rotating. You've had so many meetings with us on Monday. Hey, y'all joke around all you want, but I'm telling you, Chief and I have been talking for several months about rotating some. Y'all need to get to know every commander needs to know each region and how they operate. You've said that before. So you can joke around by now, but I'm telling you, that's in the works. And then all of a sudden, even if we came as sudden like this, we'd expect it. But, you know, man, that shit is, like you said, it's completely blown out of proportion. Something's going up.
Even in joking, what was my position on you moving? Not no, but hell no. Remember? You and Sharp would joke about it. Fuck it. Give him community services. And you was dead serious about this one time.
What changed that?
What? I never changed. Brother, I've not changed.
Dave, no one can do your job. Who's going to fucking do all that shit?
I feel like you're not hearing me, Dave. I feel like you're not hearing me.
But I'm not understanding you.
That's for damn sure. Yeah, listen to me.
But what changed that?
Nothing.
No one can do your job, Dave.
Nothing has changed.
None of these captains can fucking sit there and do what you do. All of a sudden, that shit so changed overnight.
It's not changed, brother. You've not... How has it changed?
You were going to move me over the weekend. You were going to leave. You were going to move me to... send a letter
over the weekend.
Well, I mean, you were going to send a letter today, and you were going to be on your way to D.C., and it was, you know, and you'd give me a week to whatever to transition.
You're a chief move you.
Well, that's the story. You all gotta get straight.
No.
I don't. I'm serious. You say he did it.
But
he
you know what? If we
it,
really didn't get a fuck.
That's why I tell you right now, respectful chief. I said, you know, and I'm not gonna say this anymore because I don't want you to think that I'm trying to look for any padding. Oh, David, don't leave and all that. Because I'm not, you know. When a man leaves, he makes a decision, and he the decision is made for him and his family. You know, so I don't.
And I told you that. I said I'm not gonna fucking try to change your mind.
You know, but I'm saying
I'm telling my opinion.
I'm not gonna repeat that because I don't want you to think that I'm coming across as I'm threatening. You know, everybody can be replaced.
Right.
The minute I leave this place, somebody else will be in here doing this job. Everybody can be replaced, all the way up to the chief.
And if I feel like you're serious about leaving, then I start changing my plans. I got to make my plans too.
That's right.
Do I want you to leave? Fuck no, Dave. And as a friend, I'm just telling you, I think it's a mistake. But that's just my opinion. You got to make those decisions for you and your family.
That's right.
Okay? All I'm saying is, don't make those decisions while emotions are high. You know?
I understand that.
So, I feel like you personally think I'm responsible for this. If I, and you know me, because I don't give a fuck. If I did not care about you, I'd have done that shit in a blink of an eye, made that shit solid, and then the chief would have had to undo it. Okay? But I didn't do that, because that ain't me. Alright?
It was going to happen like that.
No, it was not. I called you first.
You were about to get in the car. Yeah, you said I gave you notice. Like, how much notice? 24 hours? You told me from one day to another.
When I get told to make this shit happen, what am I supposed to do?
Tell the chief, she wouldn't even sit down and talk about this. Do we want to get David like that?
And that's what I told you. I said, you know what? In my mind, I never foresaw this being an issue. Because, honestly, from one flow to another, the relationship has not changed.
That's contradicting, chief.
How?
Because you just got finished telling me a minute ago that, you know what? I know how much pride you take in what you do and how serious you are about your job. And you just got finished that, and all of a sudden...
But I didn't know you was, like, owning this as your baby.
I didn't know... Community service was everything to me when you were a coach
right
over there.
Brother, I got moved and I hated it.
Yeah, that's right. It was, and for me, the accomplishments that we have made, again, I can break a leg today or I can die tomorrow and somebody else will be here. But I'm telling you right now, as much as he's a bitch, I'm telling you, her and I are a fucking team, man. Mm-hmm. When it comes to getting shit done for community services, it's like that.
I don't mean to sound cold, Dave. But I don't ever concern myself with those things.
Right, right.
I mean, that's your baby. But you know what? When I was moved from community services, I didn't like it. But you know what? Remember I told you these stories? When I got moved, I learned something new. And I was told, man, I did not... even the sheriff wrote me a letter fucking... And I had to thank him because I was like, wow.
Why are you doing that?
I never would have thought I would have learned something new. I'm glad that the move... Man, change is good. Change is hard, and we say this shit all the time, you know? You want to jump in anytime and say what you want to say?
You guys are talking about work. I don't know what.
No, we're talking about relationships. See, this is the dangerous thing. Because we confide in each other so much that, in my mind, and this is what my thinking is, I would have never imagined somebody on the outside could affect us to try to pit us against each other.
We failed each other on that.
No, we didn't.
Yes, we have, Chief.
How did I fail you?
No, the three of us. I'm not talking about just you and me. The three of us have failed each other because we didn't do... We're missing a person right there. We should have done this. And maybe, maybe I saw myself in the meter scale... too high of it. Maybe I'm not. Yeah. I don't measure to be, equal to you.
No, stop saying that shit.
I'm saying that because I have noticed a big difference.
Well, I confide in you on everything.
I'm not talking about you. I've noticed a big difference on the chief in my relationship.
Shit, we never see the motherfucker.
Okay, well, I'm just telling you. I've noticed a big difference, and I'm thinking, what the fuck is going on? With all this shit going on in here, I said, man, Did I say something wrong?
Bridget, a lot of times when you're with the chief, you listen to the conversations and you get a gist of what's going on. Almost consistently, we're always talking about the three of us. Consistently, okay? Never skipped a beat, all right? The one thing that only keeps us solid is that we don't let nobody else in, all right? But I've told you, you got to know the chief. Remember when he was going through his divorce? Which part?
The one thing that keeps us together is what?
That we don't let nobody get between us.
We fell on that, man. We got motherfuckers all up in our business.
Who?
Everybody, the whole department.
Who? Name one person. Name one person. You can't say that and not have a show example.
You think Scoop... No, because the shit that's out there, man. People are talking.
Okay. How do you figure that comes from me?
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. That means we are not managing this right. Something is leaking. Well, how is it leaking?
Wait a minute. Some things are just good guess. Some things are good guess. And not everything is just between us three. Now, there's secrets between us three that aren't out, obviously.
Right.
But you're talking about like the ACM job and the chief position. Those are entertained amongst people we don't even fucking know.
Right. Well, I know some of the shit was
coming. I mean, that's not...
Because of Felicia.
Brother, the secrets that we know, if they got out, would be detrimental. Okay, so no.
And I know you said on the other thing, Marvin said, but I brought them motherfuckers in here so they can keep a brief on anything they hear or said. But Felicia came up to me the other day and she Marvin deflected that. Oh, That's the first time I heard of that.
About what?
You know, oh, shit. I don't know how these damn people are in the city hall expect for people not to know shit when they're talking about
all this. Oh, brother, you can't keep no secret.
ACM. And I'm like...
That was no secret. That's not a secret. Brother, I've been politicking with all those council members and fucking other people. You don't think they're going to talk? They got to fill each other out. That's not a fucking secret. Now, if they ask me, I'll be like, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Because I don't have to fucking divulge my information.
You got someone who's got the very young, and I know that if they get out
Well, do you tell secrets?
What, to my wife?
No, I mean, shit that we do.
Oh, hell no.
Then what secrets would you talk about that we need to... Well, obviously, Bridges is, so we're going to say secrets, but...
No, what secret? I'm talking about stuff that we talk about that all of a sudden gets out, man. And we're trying to figure out... Man, your office up there, I'm telling you, it's you're looking at that, like, I'm pointing fingers at you, Randy, and myself. No, we are being sloppy as shit, Chief. Your office... You got four people sitting there listening to every fucking thing. I'm serious. I'm not trying to be disrespectful.
Okay, but what am I saying?
No, I mean, anytime we could be talking, even myself, I found myself, oh, fuck, man, I didn't even know that. People were sitting right there. I'm talking about me even being sloppy. We've gotten sloppy with this shit, man. I walk in Chief Scott's freaking thing right there. I hear you two in there. I'm like, fuck, Jimmy can hear every fucking thing they're saying.
Okay, yeah, you're right.
That's what I'm referring to, man. And as long as we continue to do that shit, you know, you guys could be talking about Sean Williams in your office, all those people, whoever's coming right there outside.
Oh, well, something is by design now. Something I want to get out.
No, I know that.
I want people to know and talk about.
I know that. There's some things, obviously not, right?
But Dave, let's get back to the root of the problem. You're upset because...
I'm not upset. You didn't see, you said that yesterday.
You're hurt. Alright, you heard about being moved, or the proposition of being moved. And so you talked to the chief one.
I'm not talking about being moved.
I mean, sometimes we just can't. If he wants it done, and I concur, I mean, I don't see designing a whole...
Past that. I don't want you to think that I'm going to be like living like, man, you guys are...
But the real root issue is you don't want to leave this position. No. You're sentimental to the position.
No, Chief's, I mean, you and Chief both already told me, this eventually is going to happen anyway, for whatever reason, whether it's for the promotion or because you guys want me to go get experience.
Right.
And I don't have a problem with that. I'm going to do well wherever I go, and you know that.
Right. Okay. So why are you making it feel like it's a bad thing?
I didn't say it was a bad thing. I said it was handled very unprofessional, I thought. That's my opinion. We all got an opinion, like an asshole, everybody's got one. It was handled very, very unprofessional, I thought. I would never would have done that to you. I would have never would have done that to Randy, not being part of the freaking the A team, not being part of the dream team. I'm serious. I mean, and see, and you can tell me shut the fuck up.
No,
I will.
I never do that.
I mean, critical. I mean, we call that what do you call that when you positive
reinforcement
or negative. Criticism? What do you say? There's something I want to say.
Say it in Spanish, huh?
No, that's the goal. But you know, when you criticize somebody professionally, or where you say positive criticism, you don't handle
creative criticism,
something like that. You know, I'm not saying you don't handle that, but I mean,
but you have to be doing something wrong for me to criticize.
Constructive criticism.
Right.
There you go. Constructive criticism.
But you have to do something for me to criticize first. If I concur with you, I'm not going to criticize you. This was strictly a strategic move. Strictly.
Man.
But you don't want to believe
when
that.
When you use that word, man, I'm like, strategic.
It's very strategic. Dave, everything we've done, the people we've fired, the people we've promoted, some good for some bad. Nothing's going to be a perfect
picture. The strategic take planning?
What about it?
The strategic take planning. I would say so, right?
Yeah, or sometimes you have to adapt on the move, though.
Well, then there's really no plan. There's no plan. That's training the kicks in, right? The strategic take planning.
You still got to execute, though. Dave, if the man say Dave needs to move, all right, then
that's a
what am I going to say?
Decision like that. That's... language.
No, strategy. We've been talking about it for a while. That's why I was, you want to believe that I think that I'm not going to listen to shredding all their files. God damn, what y'all doing? Emron up in here?
What is that?
You might want to let her know she ain't moving yet.
What's she doing?
Shredding shit like you was going out of style like y'all.
No, we do that every, we have to do that. You know how much shit comes in here?
Okay.
We do that in there?
No, I'm hearing her shredding
shit.
Oh,
so damn, somebody said she shredded everything.
Dave, short of doing it the way you want it done, there is no malicious intent, especially not on my part, about you moving. When I look at it, I'm thinking, okay, yeah, all right, Dave will do that. I'm thinking of the positives, like, all right, now I got Dave that can hang out with me, see what I do what I do, meet the people I fucking know. We haven't been able to do that. Right?
Right.
That's the way I'm thinking about it. Nothing. This whole Scott Stover thing, I didn't even know what the fuck he was talking about. I'm serious. I thought we was past that shit.
No.
You know? But you gotta remember, Chief talks to his own people. You think he didn't tell me everything?
I respect
Hell, that. I'm pretty sure Bridget knows a lot of shit about us that she ain't gonna fucking tell us.
Don't you guys think I know a lot more than I do?
You know damn a lie. You full of shit. You know?
Sorry.
But I respect that, you know? But I, knowing that about you, I don't fucking give you a hard time.
I think one of the issues is, though, everybody interprets each other's relationship with him differently and feels threatened by it. Which, what's the point in that?
What do you mean
by that?
Like you're threatened by us?
No. But my relationship is completely different than the relationship that you two have with him.
Well, obviously.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah.
But you can't get mad if he tells one of you something and not the other.
No.
No, we don't.
We don't do that.
But now, if he plays us against one another, then the rule is...
That's not him. That's him. That's not good. Just the same thing, you know. But shoot it straightforward. This is the reason why we're doing it. That's what, you know, that's it. This is the plan. But, you know, being caught up on you one story and another, no, he said it. I didn't say it. No, he's the one that told me, you know.
Yeah, but do you think for one second, say Randy Scott was sitting right here and we was having this discussion, do you really think it'd be productive? Be for real, Dave. What would happen? What would Randy Scott do?
How would we know if it wasn't if we don't try it?
Dave, it don't take a rocket scientist.
No,
it don't take the rattlesnake sitting there whether or not, guessing whether they're going to bite you if you put your hand out there.
That's true, but I mean, I guess I always try to, you know, think a little bit positive and say, you know.
Well, you've always been great at that.
You know, let's give it a shot and see. Shit, I actually learned a lot that, you know, from you.
Well, the whole thing, like with you being concerned about the divorce and the stuff he was going through when he was going through, man, that's admirable. That's what a real friend does. And we all felt that way. And you asked me. Okay, go ahead.
Hey, let me call you right back. Hey, let me call you right. Huh? Museum.
What about it? Road closure?
The museum for the Crime Stoppers. Oh, I have to get the address, brother. That's in West Columbia.
Oh, you're supposed to be at that.
Oh, shit. Okay, Chief Weiser should be there. He said he was going too. He wanted to see what it was like, so. Damn, I'm not there, brother. I'm
in
the
meeting with
DC.
All right? Man, what time did that start?
That's Felder. Same freaking live. This is the last time, remember? Oh, I walked in. He walked in at the end of the meeting, and Colin told me that. But, no, but Chief Weiser, I saw him walking about an hour ago, so he must have
been. Yeah.
Anyway.
What time was the meeting?
12 o'clock.
Shit.
Oh, he missed all the freaking...
Yeah. But the fact of the matter is, there's nothing we wouldn't do. Even when he pisses on us, you even said it, God damn, even when he shits on us, we still can't help ourselves but to try to help him. But we've always said at the same time, you think he would do the same thing for us? You know?
Yeah, well, a long time ago I did.
Right.
A long time ago I did, and I don't know, that's why I was telling you guys a minute ago, I don't know what's happened here.
Well, Bridget's in the same boat.
You know?
We're not talking. I know it sounds like we're talking maliciously, but we're telling the truth,
no,
right?
No, but the thing about it is this.
I mean, your relationship ain't perfect.
But what do people do for a relationship that isn't perfect? They seek help. They talk about it. They
But it takes two. It takes two.
You're absolutely right. But if you don't give,
what would happen if you asked, "Hey, look, can we go to counseling?"
It wouldn't go over well.
Or, "Hey, you need to go see a counselor."
Right. I just know from things that he's told me about things that have happened. He doesn't want me to tell him what he needs to do.
He'll shut down.
Well, he's already told us that. I mean, nobody's going to tell him what to do anymore. Right. We understand that. But
he will shut down, and then we're fucked.
Well, and I feel that that's one of the reasons why he has withdrawn from me, because...
And I told you. Remember I told you that?
This with him.
Yeah. You know, remember when I told you that?
Achieve, you know. Yeah.
I said, "Dave, I said, if you do that, he's going to just limit his, he's going to just cut you off, and then you only, he only, it's the same conversation you said when you said, and I, you know, I've always respected you for being honest with me, and I told you I want that." You said, "Ruben, respectfully, I think you enable him." She's told me that shit too, right? Mm-hmm. She'll tell me, "God damn, why the fuck you do that?" And my,
you're not
and
helping
my,
him by doing that. You
well,
know that.
Right. But what I'm trying to do is open up a little bit more communication. He's opened up a lot more and he's told me some of the stuff that I already knew, but at least he's now telling me. And you know? And at least now he's got somebody. Now, our relationship is different. Bridget's is more, you know, on the intimate side. Mine's professional. He uses me as a sounding board. We don't talk about shit and we'll say the same things 15 times, but at least it's an outlet for him, you know? At least now he's got someone he can talk to, say things, at least he hears him say it, and then help him make better decisions. And that, yeah, it makes me sick to my stomach that I feel like I've got to be his cheerleader in those things, you know? I don't agree with everything he says. I'll be like, "Well, Chief, you know, I think we need to do this." And then he'll tell me, "Shut the fuck up," or "Nah."
Yeah, and I understand that. You're his consultant, you know? You consult with him.
Right.
And got his advisor.
But I can tell you, there's times when he calls me, he goes, "I need you to do this, and motherfucker, don't you tell nobody. Or I need you to do this, and don't ask me who the fuck I talk to."
You know,
yeah, all the time. It's like a common phrase with him.
No, but it's funny because, yeah. Yeah. Hey,
Debbie. Hey. I got it. Yeah. Yeah, I'm actually in here right now. Yeah. Yeah, I appreciate it. Yeah. Nah, I know what the fuck y'all doing.
Right.
At least what it looks like. See, if I was in Debbie's shoes right now, I'd be like, "Oh, those motherfuckers doing an Enron right now. Damn, shredding everything, fuck the world. Here you go, bitches."
No, I wouldn't do that.
You see how he looked down into the right?
No,
You see how his little voice got a little lower?
I would gladly pass all this responsibility.
No, you won't. You know why? Because you and I are built the same. Brother, we love misery when it comes to fucking getting a job done. We love it. We want the tough jobs. We want the challenges. And we know damn well that's the truth.
No doubt about that. Yeah. I mean,
as much as we bitch and moan about it, that's what we want.
Well, that's our nature, man. That's what we brought up as far as our professional careers. No doubt about that. But, man, I'm glad you stopped by, Chief. I appreciate, you know, you...
It's the part where he says, "Get the fuck out."
Oh, no. You're the boss. No.
Dave, I'm your friend first. I've never acted like that. You know that. I mean, you've been my confidant, you know? Where's the Chief's confidant? We're his friend. But you know, who do I got? Who do I got?
We have to, I ain't trying to get religion, but I'm praying for our friendship, man. Not yours and not at all.
Man, you make it sound like I done did something wrong to you, brother.
I just think that...
Why can't I be the victim? Can I be the victim this time?
Yeah, I'm saying all three of us. I'm not saying just you and I, and you know, I'm talking all three of us. I said, man, this could be, you know, if we don't do things right here, man. You look at that motherfucker the other day. Man, no one is untouched. Look at that motherfucker, that sheriff over there, wherever it was. USC. State. I mean, shit.
You know who used to work with him? Bradley?
Yeah, Bradley, that's right.
And Dave, But this is the thing. And you got to believe this. I mean, when you truly have faith in somebody, no matter what someone else tells you, you won't believe it until you talk to that person and they give you something to think otherwise. You know what I mean? Like right now, someone came to me and said, "Rude, man, I was just in the car. Dave just said all fucked up shit about you, da 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 da." I'm not gonna believe it. I'm like, "Dave? Nah, man, bullshit." You know? Until I talk to you and you tell me otherwise. That's how strong I believe in our friendship.
And you know, and honestly, I have one regret, and I told you and I apologized the other day, is that same day, this was before the promotion that was due to Dwayne, Ronnie, or him. And that day he jumped in my car and there, and I told him, I said, "Brother, I cannot promise you what they're going to do. That I know Ruben and Randy are looking at Green, they're looking at Ronnie, and they're looking at, oh, Marvin, and they're looking at freaking, you know, at you." I said, "But I don't know, they only got one fucking stripe, dude, one corporal slot. So I don't know if you're going to get it." And I said, "I would love for you to get it because he was killing it on Felder, dude. Every fucking day, Felder, get me away from that dumb motherfucker. He don't know what he's doing, blah, blah, blah." And now, obviously, I'm the dumb motherfucker now. He wants to get rid of me. Okay? So
you all think he did the same thing with me?
Well, I bet. Yeah. He thinks he's just too smart for the world, man. Right. And I will tell you that he said, "Rather than do it, you can do it." I'm telling you right now, the big thing is right now that we brought you for that crime prevention program that you got, man. And for us to flourish and to freaking take off with this thing, they probably gonna lean more towards making you the corporal. "Man, brother, you brought me here. I trust you, but I'll be honest with you. I hope you don't learn the hard way. I don't, Ruben and Chris Collin, fuck me. I hope you don't learn the hard way." I said, "Well, you know what? That might have been the Ruben you knew, and I don't even know if that happened. I'm not saying that happened or whether it happened.
Never happened.
But if he did that to you, I said, you need to get to know." That's what friends do, man. I said, "You need to get to know this new Ruben. You don't know if he was not, what was he, a sergeant, a corporal? Man, think about the influences that he might have had over him to do his job." Mm-hmm. So don't judge him on that. He's in a top position now, a whole different ballgame. Give him that opportunity.
But you know my philosophy.
Meanwhile, and look what he does with this shit, man.
We don't know if that's the case, Dave.
Chief, I know.
How?
Because Felder has told me over and over and over
again. Let's call him in and ask him. But it's going to come at a price, though.
Felder's told me, "Chief, that motherfucker, our captain, that motherfucker's after you.
Give me a Bible. I will swear on it that I've never had a conversation about anything that you did with reference to him."
That what he told me about you is the opposite of what happened right now. That's what he's doing.
But I have not talked with the man.
No.
I literally brought him up there only for this fucking special response protocol.
And Jimmy and
that's just gonna be big on the news today. Watch.
I bet. I read the thing. The article was very nice. Yeah. That's what Jennifer did.
But Dave, the weakness, and don't take this wrong, like the weakness that you have.
No, we don't have weaknesses. Yeah, man, please.
Is that you care so much and you're very passionate. To the point where if anyone shows any resentment towards that or attacks you, then you attack right back. And that sometimes gives you, it makes them have an opening on you. You know what I mean? An opening on us.
Right.
And, you know, me and the chief even talked about, I was like, some things, yeah, we don't tell you because we don't want to upset you. You know, we hear all the time, "Oh man, Navarro's hard to work for. Hey, well, he's doing everything we're asking him to do." You think I could go back and say, "Dad, man, so and so said that, man, you're a motherfucker."
And at the same time, I'm telling you the same thing I told him before. I am structured. That's the way I would. That's all I bring is my military. I'm gonna take that to the grave. But if there's something in here that I'm not doing the way you guys want me to do it, I'm going overboard. I know.
I would tell you. Even outside of that, more of a friend. What is the one thing I said? I said, "Dave, you know what? If someone's fucking up, I'm going to tell them. I'm straight up. If we got to fire someone, we're going to tell them." Brother, I had to fire Albert Richardson, who's not a close friend of mine, but I went to school with him. I know his family, everything. That was probably the toughest one to do because you want to believe maybe there's a chance they didn't do this, you know? And I have to tell myself, "Ruben, I've got to stick to what I said was going to happen." And that's where Randy messed up with Shannon Williams and Andre Williams. He got very soft-hearted in the fact that, all right, I can't do this, you know? That's what happened when he decided to change his mind on the transfer, you know? He has a, such a heart that if he knows it upsets you, he doesn't want to make you unhappy. You know what I'm saying?
So don't you think that, I'm glad you said that, Chief.
I'm serious.
So don't you think that the same way he changed his mind when I called him, he would have changed his mind if you told him, Chief, let's sit down and talk about this. This is about it.
Yeah.
What? Let's not do Dave like that.
Right.
That's what I'm at with.
But I didn't think it was a bad idea at the time, Dave. I don't think it's a bad idea because I think you're looking at it as a bad thing.
No, see, we're not even...
Okay, laws were clear on that.
We cannot get past that. I'm talking about the...
Well, maybe I'm looking at... I guess I'm looking at it from my spot. Because when I was in your spot and they moved me, brother, my heart was broke. I loved that unit so much that I could not see myself doing nothing else. Literally, at that time. So I took all that to account.
This is the biggest and most powerful unit in the department.
That's true.
I'm not taking anything away from anybody else, but everything comes.
You know what's bigger than that, though? When you're the deputy chief.
Right. No, I understand that. Right. I agree with that.
And that's why one thing I had a concern about is you getting too attached to this and lose sight of where we need to go.
I'm not going to turn down a promotion.
I know that. You'd be like, fuck that. Community service is what?
Exactly. I'm not going to turn down a promotion. But,
sometimes you have to line things up to stay the course. And one of the things the chief is going to look at is like, shit, if Dave's going to be that, you know, if it's going to be that big of a deal to him, I'm just throwing, like, maybe what he's thinking. If it's going to be that big of a deal to him, damn, I don't know if that's going to be enough. If that's going to be too much responsibility.
Chief, the hard thing, you know, the hard part of me understanding some of that stuff you're trying to tell me right now is the fact that we talked about, you know, initially I was chewing on that and I was, you know, I was chewing that and I was feeding that to my guys. And I said, my guys, Ronnie, the ones that came from Richmond County with us, or, you know, Jason, the rest of those guys, they talked to me often about perception. Well, I'll be honest with you, and I'm not taking anything away from anybody. I dare the motherfucker come talk about perception about Marvin with us. That's how, that motherfucker's taking that fucking recruiting thing to a whole different level.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not saying he won't do no wrong. He can do wrong. Maybe there's things that he can improve. But that motherfucker came here to, maybe the canine part, you know, and you and I mean, that was one of the best fucking moves we made with that motherfucker in there.
But do you think Chief Scott recognizes that?
Well, that's not good. That's not good. And then see, even
it's not in his realm to think about those things.
Right. Well, because we're making a lot of stuff. We're the ones connected to that. You know, ain't nobody can say a fucking thing about Ruben Santiago not coming here to work fucking work. Not one person. I tell him, kiss my ass, suck. Kiss my ass, right? You know, and hope to die and all that stuff, right? And the same thing, I'll be honest with you, you know, and I say that humbly. No one in there is going to call, you came here, get a fucking pretty ass black charger. No, motherfucker, I came here to work. I have worked. I have worked my motherfucking ass off to do, you know, and I even told Chief when, you know, we talked a couple of times about switching cars. I said, you know what, give me a regular, you know, one of the Oakland Victorias. It pays for my gas. I'm past that, you know, but you try and explain right now that, you know, there are certain things that, and I hope you see where you're going, that there's certain things that we have to do. You know what? That perception shit got to go out the fucking window when it comes to certain things, not all things. The reason why? Ori. And I know he's been here 2015 years. I don't know. What was he? Sergeant, lieutenant, captain, mail run, sergeant, lieutenant, captain. What's the perception of? We're doing just as much work as they are. I'm bringing 14 years of law enforcement career with Richmond County and 20 years of military. That's 34 freaking years of experience. Fuck that perception when it comes to certain people.
Respectfully,
sir. Huh?
And
the fucking education. I mean, I don't want to hear that bullshit, but you got to go send me to fucking go work a region to somebody that got to be.
Well, when you put it like that,
does
you're
it
right.
take, huh? Does it take, right, Chief?
No, you're right.
You know?
When you put it like that, you're right. Brother, I didn't say I didn't make a mistake. Remember I told you, I said, you're right. It probably could have been done different. You know?
Thank you. Thank you for saying that. Thank you. That's what I wanted to hear.
I've been trying to say that.
I've been trying to beat this dead horse, and I finally, obviously, I put it together better than I could have.
Well,
I mean,
when you put it like that, you're 100% right.
I mean, you know? Nobody can fucking stand anything. You tell me that all the time. Not one of these motherfuckers can do what you do, Dave.
They can't.
So why do we need to justify to anybody that I can go run and read
you? But it's not my show yet. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but you can fight that.
You're right.
You gotta stand up to the lion. Sometimes you gotta stand up for him, Chief. I'm telling you.
No, you're right.
You know what? And I'm gonna tell you this, I'm gonna hold you accountable for this. He listens to you a lot too. Yes, he does. I've been there. I've been there when you have interrupted him. No, you don't interrupt him. You're very respectful of that, but you say, "But Chief, you know, blah 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 blah. You're right. You're right about that. Let's do it like that." And he listens to you a lot too.
Man.
You know? Again, I don't know what my lines of communication were then.
No, man, brother, he loves you. Tell him that. You know that.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly.
Yeah.
No. She knows
he's
it.
He's the
she
only
hears.
Person I've seen at the house other than his mom.
Yeah. No, he's got issues going on.
I know that. We all know that. That's what we're talking about.
And that's
right
what's
now.
Heartbreaking too. It's like, fuck. My only motivation for getting him promoted is so that we can reduce the stress level, give him an area where he can manage things, you know, and we can take care of him. There'll be less eyes on him, you know, professionally. That's my only way. Fuck being police chief. You know that? Obviously, I want it if he goes up, because then that kind of fucks us off. Some stranger comes in. But my only hopes is that, because I know he's not going to listen to us when we say, "Dude, you got some fucking issues, and that you're crazy, and you got fucking mental problems. You're going to shut down." It is almost a constant race to think, shit, is today going to be the day where the shit fucking blows up? And I'm just like praying to God, please let him get that assistant city manager. He's great at the broad sense of things, you know? But here you got too many time commitments, too many issues happening from bombardments. And he's too high profile. That look at all these superstars. That's why they fucking fall to pieces, you know? This police chief job should not be a celebrity position. We created that. It's actually our fault. Remember we always talking about rebranding and putting his name and the banner on? That's why I'm trying to wean that down a little bit, because we kind of went overboard. Well, you know, we've created the celebrity chief.
Right. And I know that position itself is a rock star position, you know? You're right. I mean,
but it shouldn't be. It should be about business.
Well, that's very true. But I'm gonna be honest with you. I mean, you and I've talked about that. He goes over there. He's gonna turn into a man in a suit. That's it. Just like Mr. Baker.
Well, don't tell him that. Because on his ego.
Nobody fucking know who Mr. Baker is. I mean,
right.
The only exception with Randy and him that Randy is a superstar right now, and people know him from Richland County and here.
Right.
Mr. Baker, I don't know. Yeah, I guess he's from procurement or whatever he was doing.
It'd be a better suit for him because he's a more of a talker and a schmoozer and a coordinator. When you get into this job, you're fucking got to execute orders and you got to put together plans and strategies. That's where the stress level comes in.
You're absolutely right, Jason. But going back to what we just said, you know, and I mentioned this to you. You give me a great example, sir, as to why if I measure up to you guys the way you say I measure up to you, and I've done the things that you have said, you both tell me how much you love me. And you know, if I would have came here and failed you guys, man, fuck that. Yeah, he need to go to a region. But why do you feel the need to prove anything to Magmar, Jimmy, Randy? You know, I got, like you said, the qualifications, the training, the experience, 34 fucking years.
No, right.
I'm 52 years old. I'm not to tell somebody go I'm 35. Yeah, he needs
Let
to
me
go
tell you
around.
What I just came to realization of. You're 100% right. And this is actually something that, remember I told you about, my biggest fear is that we come here and we get assimilated into the old ways. Remember? I said
right.
that? I said my worst fear is that we start conforming to what everyone else in the city does. And actually, this is a little bit of that. You know, I've conformed into trying to make a smooth transition. I think the chief is also, we all conformed a little bit because you're right. You just named off three people that have gotten three promotions in 2 years.
That's right.
You know? Fuck. Who will be promoted in the Richland County side?
None. Nobody.
We're so caught up. What I just realized, we're so caught up with trying to create an image that we're not them.
That's right.
That we're us.
We're
that,
us.
That we sacrificed.
Why are we punishing ourselves like that?
You're right. You're 100% right,
you know,
Dave.
That man right there has told me you three have done more for this department in 2 years than half of this freaking crew ran around here with 20 plus years. And he probably speaking for himself.
No, but, he recognized that.
Well, okay, you see what I'm saying? So I'm thinking, what perception are we worrying about?
I'm sold, Dave.
And the only thing I say to that, Chief, thank you for accepting that, is that, you know, that you stand up for what is right. And even with our brother, you tell him, man, listen, I disagree with that. I think we need to discuss that a little bit more. Leave him where he's at. Why make him unhappy? Leave him where he's at. Oh, if you're going to promote him, let's promote him. We don't need to prove nothing to nobody about Dave. Dave has done it just as you've done it.
You're right.
Who can say anything about you? Nobody can. Yeah. I dare.
So what kind of damage control we need to do with the chief?
Nothing.
You sure in the heat of your being heartbroken, you're saying crazy shit?
Yeah, I told him, I said, shit, I'm honest, I'm considering leaving. I told him that.
Oh, I thought maybe you just told him how we talk so much shit about.
No, and I know you know how he gets upset.
Hey, just so you know, I got a VA appointment.
Okay, well.
So I may have my phone on.
You gotta go see the chief or something?
No.
Common courtesy.
You need to find a good confidant, though, in the department that's going to, in your unit, okay, that's going to tell you the pulse of things, because you do have to play some politics on that, Dave.
So what now?
If I was you, I would try to find someone like Marv or somebody who's got a good pulse of your unit to tell you what's working, what's not working. Because, I mean, you could be a hard man to work for.
Why didn't you tell me that a long time ago?
I just thought, I'm just now thinking about this shit because you're telling me about Stover and stuff.
But I'm telling you, these guys are different. This guy, I'm going to tell you what's going on. And you may agree or disagree with that. I thought I had that on Felder. Felder thinks he's coming here to take, he thinks this is his. So he,
maybe in the future.
The way he does that, he's trying to win over his
life. Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? I'm your buddy.
Okay, I
see. Come to me. And I thought I had that in him. And you know, I told him, I said, brother, we got to be like a husband and wife.
Yeah.
You got to be able to tell me, and I got to be able to come to you. And we had that going all of a sudden, there and there with him all day, same shit that Jimmy always doing when he was here.
But you got to let, you know, fuck it, let him think of that, because you got yours, you know?
Right.
We don't need to try to keep something that's really not ours. Let him aspire to be in this position.
Okay.
And win those guys. That's why I always tell you, Dave, you're so hands-on that I think you piss off your supervisors because you're so hands-on. It's a good thing. But then for them, they're like, fuck, when am I going to get to prove myself, you know?
I see what you're saying.
And I did that. Remember I did that with you? And I was just so hands-on. I'm like, fuck. And you had to pull me aside. I said, look, when are you going to let me do this shit?
I told, yeah, and you're absolutely right. You know, I'm mission structure, man.
I know.
Last week I called freaking Chris Williams. Hey, send me Chris out. I got to take $300.
Oh, that's, you got to have the luxury of doing that.
You see what I'm saying?
You got to.
When he told me, sir, respectfully, he didn't even respect with my ass. He said, sir, are you keeping him all day? Is this going to be one of those all day things? I said, would you tell that to Chief Santiago?
Yeah,
Chief,
they gotta learn.
I said, you know what? Don't worry about it. I got it. I said, I'll take care of it. And Stacy and I did it.
Yeah, they gotta learn how to take it.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, you don't freaking ask your supervisor no shit. Like,
well,
that.
Let's do this. I'll talk with the chief. I mean, it sounds like he's already said this whole thing, so we'll talk later. But we need to focus on making sure that, like, the Scott Stover thing does bother me. And I stick to what I said, Dave. I hope you know how important our relationship is.
Well, I think right now, Scott, honestly, and I'm going to tell you this, right, I think Scott, he's done the smart thing. He's made himself so marketable with his crime prevention thing that, and I'll be honest with you, you know that. I mean, let's not sugarcoat this. He knows he's very marketable that, you know what, fuck these motherfuckers. I got him right where I want him. I don't have to listen to nobody. And the only thing I'm asking you right now, listen, why not just put him in special operations?
We can do that. I just don't.
I mean,
at the same time, though, I think it would make it look like you can't deal with him. And that's a bad thing, you know.
Chief, I'm telling you, he does not like me.
It reminds me of Roxanne Metz.
He has reached the point of wishnik with me.
I'm telling you, he's there with Wishnick. He's fucking Wishnick. Yeah. I don't know what else to tell.
I'm actually happy that you have to deal with him and I don't. Because I used to be the direct supervisor to Stover. I know. That's what matter I told you. I know Stover. You know?
You tried to tell me that shit. Are you sure you want to? He told me that. Are you sure you want to bring him over here? Are you sure you want to bring him over here? And he ain't out. Yes. And look how I fucking get compensated with this shit. I'm telling you.
But you know, hey, I'm still hurt that you think. I'm still hurt that you think that I would be malicious towards you. That really bothers me, Dave.
Malicious? Who said that?
No, that you would think I'm taking these actions on you on behalf of somebody else's agenda. Brother.
No, I think that you
have. You got to believe that.
I don't think that you're doing that. I think that you are overlooking the sensitivity of this issue with Stover.
Okay.
You know?
I didn't know Scott was an issue until today.
It's very serious. I mean, and you know, me as a commander, I should be able to come to you and say, boss, this is not working out. I've tried everything I can. There's no reason why a memo that is addressed to the entire division,
right,
like that memo that I sent to Wagner, that respond, I sent it to the whole community. Perfect example of what professional. He, you know, and I included you on that email so that he don't have to worry about sending it to you, because he's going to forward it to you, I promise you.
What?
Why does he need to say that? What does the captain need to say that? It's addressed to the entire division, but he takes it. I asked Felder, why does he take that personal with him? I don't know, Captain, I'm telling you. That's just the way he is.
Yeah. All right, we good?
We've been good.
You ain't been leaving, are you?
Oh, I'm praying about it.
Don't leave, Dave. No. Trust me on this one, man. We got a ray of sunshine at the end of this tunnel, okay? It's going to get better, all right? Bridget is going to help us.
She talking about leaving the USC.
I know, trust me.
Yeah.
Doesn't this conversation seem familiar?
What?
Well, I was trying to explain, trying to tell you don't leave.
Don't leave.
I even thank you yesterday. Don't go.
I'm serious. Don't leave. You guys, it's going to get better. We need to hold the course. We need to be steadfast. And I'm telling you, shit is going to work out. All right? Shit's going to work out.
Well,
the best thing we can hope for the chief is we need to reduce his stress level. He doesn't recognize the stress level. You know that. Come on. He doesn't recognize it. But because he doesn't recognize it, it's affecting him and it's affecting the job here. You know? And the last thing I want to happen is something bad for him, you know? Because then it's bad for all of us. No matter what, you, me, and him will always be grouped together.
That's right, and you know, I kind of
his failures will be our failures.
I kind of like what we did that one day, and that when we were in his room, you know, yeah, I know that was not more of a social thing. We were in there kind of chatting, you know, shooting the shit and laughing and joking. But sometimes it's necessary for us to see where we're at with each other in this department. You know, what you know that I don't know, what he knows that I don't know, and share that stuff. And instead of me and you, you know, and again, this is not about me. Ruben, I'm past that shit. I'm 52 years old. I want you to know, I ain't trying to shine. You know, I'm telling you this. I promise you from the bottom of my heart.
Might mean that, but that's not your character.
Well, no, I'm telling you. I'm telling you right now, if I leave here, I'm not going for rank. I'm going to try to get my experience officer position, and I'm going to be okay.
Dave, let me tell you what I fear. And I'm not trying to scare you. And I pray to God this never happens.
Oh, my God, it's 2 years.
I know. As soon as you leave here, you know how the retirees, man, it'll be like 2 years later they pass away. And man, I think about it.
God damn, I'm going to say I'm going to die. God damn.
I'm going to do everything I can to keep them here. If you leave me, I don't want to say it like that.
And if I stay, look at that. I got to watch my back with these motherfuckers on here,
That's
man.
The beauty of it. We love these challenges. Mm-hmm. Why do you think I wear my shit all the fucking time?
Damn, I didn't even see that either. I'm glad I wore this motherfucker today, but I was like,
I don't even know what email you're talking about.
The one you say, wear your fucking shit.
I
read it this morning. I'm like, oh shit, you know?
That was really for Jimmy.
No. That chief, we need that.
Jimmy and Mars.
I saw that.
5-11.
Whenever they want, Monday through Friday and one day of the week. If it's a SWAT call out, I can understand
right.
You know, or training or whatever they got. But you're right. But I don't get into all that. That's for the deputy chief.
We have to figure out how to help Bridget too. Bridget, what can we do to help you to help us, help him?
I don't know.
You're not a great
putter. How can I get in the middle of this mess?
Huh? I really brought you down because I wanted him to know that, look, well, I mean, you did validate that, you know, it's always been us three, and it's always been, you know, if the chief needs something done, he's not going to always tell us what he wants done, and sometimes we just have to do what he wants done, you know, and sometimes it ain't the best thing, but.
If I complain to either one of you about him, it's not because I'm gonna go after him or I hate him.
We don't.
Right,
right.
No, and that's why we want you to talk to us. But we gotta promise. We gotta bring in the fold. We gotta make sure, as a pack, that no matter what we say, we keep it between us. You know? I think we all have the same objective when it comes to Randy. But it's one of them things, I don't want him to be a statistic, you know? And as much as we like to see these shows about intervention and how they work, there's a lot that don't work. And maybe I'm wrong, I just don't see it working with him.
Does he not want to be serious in a relationship right now?
Yes, he does.
He needs a family.
He doesn't know how.
He talked to me the other day, man.
Let me tell you what.
I was telling you about that shit. I said, man, I'm telling you, I think he's going to change. Because he started telling my man, you know what, Dave? You know, and I'm like, what is this all about? You know, he says, man, I'm telling you, man, I love you and Angie, man. You guys got the perfect, I'm like, you guys got the perfect family, man. You guys have been part of my life for so long, and you know, and I tell you, you're the perfect role model. And I'm thinking, boy, you're going through depression, man. I mean, what is that all about? I mean, we've been around each other for a long, long time. You know, and I said, Chief, I love you for that. Thank you for saying all those nice things. And we are honored that you hold us at the level that you hold us in your heart. You know, I told him that. And I said, you know, the feeling is mutual. I saw what you put on Facebook for Angie and I. But at the same time, I was bothered with it. But I'm like, man, he needs help. He's crying for help.
That's like her.
He's crying for help and nobody sees it.
Remember how he always tries to tell us?
That's the 52 years old of me coming in. I'm telling you the truth.
No, it's not that validate this for me. It's just hard to talk to him about it.
Yeah. Validate this for me. As much, he's always talking about, oh, man, and you know, I need Bridget to get away from me, and I need this and this and this. But in the same breath, he'd be like, hey, I think I'm in love with her. I don't want to be without her. And you see it, because, hell, until I really got to talk to her, I didn't get to see the other side of Randy Scott, you know? And, dude, it was like scary, Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde, because, you know, it would have been easier to believe him over you, you know? And I'm like, wait a minute, it says backwards. He's trying to be with her. But that's where we gotta, with us three, we gotta make sure we stay tight, you know? All right.
Boss, before you leave here, what are we gonna do about stores?
Let's think on it. We can't make it look like, and this is along your lines, we can't make it look like you can't handle it, you know what I mean? But we can't make it seem like he's getting his way either.
Other than giving him the freedom that I told him, I said, brother, you don't have to come through here. You can go straight to a lieutenant. I told him, I said, I don't need to see him because obviously my physique breaking.
That's what I'm, honestly.
It stresses him. You can see it in his face. Right. As soon as he sees me, his chain, his face gets red.
But so, that's what I'm saying. Instead of dealing with him, let him, instead of you dealing with any of these guys, let the lieutenant deal with it.
You, and I've been doing that.
Your leadership role is already established. And your philosophies are already established. And when they don't do what you say to do, whatever directives, yeah, you hold their asses in check. But I'll be honest with you, I know you. It's hard to do that because you're very hands-on. It was hard for me to do that. You know, instead of going to the lieutenant and saying, Lieutenant, I need you to call so-and-so and make it happen.
I've been doing that a lot more, but yeah. I'm going
to
work
like
on that.
Like, I should have called you when I called Stover up there in reference to the special response protocol, you know? I'm like, fuck. I'm just so used to, all right, let me call Stover, bam. Because we had to get this done today.
Otherwise, right, no, we wouldn't know that. Otherwise, Casey and what's going on, and then we'll release them. I mean, I was going to give you that.
Yeah, right?
And I understand that.
That was my...
That lieutenant, you know, he's going to cuss my ass out.
No, just say, hey, look, I had no idea these motherfuckers would do it.
That's why you asked me all those questions. That's
you should have told him we were doing it.
No, I didn't tell him. I said, hey, what are y'all planning on doing? Oh, no, we're fixing to launch this program. I said, that motherfucker. I'm not even
this is all over the news right now.
I know. He's going to be like, that motherfucker took my shit, went on the internet, not knowing that we've already been discussing it. But I did tell him, I said, no, we're actually looking at the same program. I just want to know, find out, I know you say you don't want to, that doesn't really give me an answer, honestly, and I know we can't do that. You leave him tomorrow.
What would you like to do?
Huh? I'm telling you, why don't we just freaking put him in with Randy Martin?
You would put all the crime prevention?
Yeah, and under Randy Martin. Gee, we did that before.
Okay.
You can put the canine unit over there.
It's just a very big cell since it's so closely.
Yeah, but what's the difference? He's not moving. The only thing he's moving, there's nothing. His new boss is Randy Martin. And you know what my point with that is? Pay attention. Now Dave Navarro's out of the picture. Man, Lord Jesus, help us. I'm going to tell you, you're not going to tell me because you're going to say that motherfucker. You're going to have to go back and say, motherfucker, you were right.
I don't have a problem saying that. You know that.
I wish you would have been talking about it. I think I'm at that point with him. Every time he comes in here, Verna sees it on his face. Man, it completely changes his. Like, see, his face gets puffed up, and I'm like, that's not him.
There's no doubt in my mind he's got some mental issues. No doubt.
So what are we going to do about it? It's my thing. I'm asking you, Chief. I'm begging you.
Right, fuck it, I'll do it, but I'm going to do it just to trust you on this one, all right?
Yeah, and I'm asking you, you want to give me something else? You want me to take the desk? I'll take the desk.
You sure?
I'm serious. I'll take the fucking desk.
Okay.
I'll take the desk. I don't want the desk. I'll give you the desk.
All right. We'll do it today, man.
Okay.
Is that too soon, or should we?
No. We've been talking about it. Okay. And boss, the last thing I ask is, man, when you talk to the big boss, man, stand up for what.
I'll show you. I will. You know, there's always room for improvement.
Big advisor, man. Look. You're the chief right now. Wiser is not. He listens to you, man. Yeah. Not more than you think he does, man. You don't give yourself that much credit, but I've been sitting there with y'all when you have corrected him and said, you're right, Roman, you're right. Let's do it like that. And I just don't think that, he may throw something at you like, okay, yes, let's move it. Because you want to please him, but brother, I hope that you hold me, I'm not asking for any special favors. All I'm asking is what is due to me. If you want me to, don't even want to give me a pay raise. I'm fine with that, but I just want to be treated, with a due regard. That's all.
Right.
You know?
Okay. Alright.
Thank you.
Can you get another hug?
Yeah.
Brother, you know I love you, man. Come on. It hurt my feeling you think that I would ever. I know. Because I look at it like, man, if he thinks that, then how quickly would he do it to me? You know? We gotta remember the past.
Yeah, well, we both thinking that way. That's what I'm telling you, that this triangle needs to be happening,
And Sean ain't gotta do no damage to the chief. He didn't sound right this morning.
What did he say to you?
I don't know if he was half awake or half asleep. I think he actually slept.
You tell me that shit all the time. So, what are you talking about? What did you say?
First he said, hold off. I got an email at 3:00 in the morning. I didn't get it till this morning. Hold off on the move. I called him at 7:00. And it sounded like he was half asleep, but he's like, no, don't make the move. We got to talk about some other things. So, I said, okay.
Like what?
I don't know. I figured maybe you said that we had some kind of conspiracy against
him.
With the whole me meeting Chief Austin type deal.
We talked about the,
I mean, if you did, just let me know so I can craft some kind of bullshit.
No, the thing. What I told him was about this shit with the way it was handled. I just told him I didn't think. I said, really? I mean, is that what you guys hold? I mean, you guys are still down. I mean, we would have been over this, And he said, and the fucking finger pointing started. I didn't do it. He did it. You did it. And I'm like, man, this is crazy.
what I think happened was, because the chief is very hands-on too, you know, he's out of his feelers. I would assume, putting two together, something you did affected somebody that works for you, they told him, and he was like, well, maybe we need to move, about moving. So when he mentions it to me, I actually said, actually, you know, we've been talking about that for months. That might be a good time. And I said, I'll make it happen. You know? They said, okay. Then you talked to him, and he called me and said, hold on, don't make a move. Then I text you back. Done. It was the end of the story. I didn't even talk to him. 2 or 3 hours later, he calls me back. Man, damn, Rube, look. Go ahead and make the transfer. Just make the transfer. I said, all right, I don't have a problem doing it. I'll talk to him. I don't have a problem doing it. And he goes, that way, you know what? And he was joking. He goes, this way, because you're the chief. You make the decision. And then if he says something, then I'll take the hit.
Well, there you go. You told him exactly what you just tell him exactly what he wanted to hear.
But only because I told you I already strategically thought about how this could be an advantage. I didn't look at it as a bad thing. Honestly, I didn't. You know?
And you know,
we've talked about it. I see your points. Your right, can be handled different. You know, in some cases we can do it that way. In some cases we can't.
Can you look up strategic opportunity here and see if it takes planning?
It don't take no planning. Strategic means best advantage. Now planning, you want to take a best advantage.
I know.
You and I gotta sit down and play chess.
Yes, you're right.
Bridget, any words of wisdom? Anything we can do to help?
No.
How's the good chief doing?
Good, as far as I know.
Were you there last night? Is he okay?
Yeah.
Did he bring my hotspot? Fuck no.
I don't know. He brought paperwork to Debbie. He was here earlier.
Was he pissed? You want to give some insight? Give us a heads up on some shit. I know he confides in you in a lot of stuff.
When he confides, he doesn't confide the way you guys think. He gets angry with me. Not with you guys.
Get the fuck up type thing.
Well, I know what she does, because you do exactly what Faith does. You state the obvious and how fucked up it is and how we need to make a change. Without taking all the other things. And then so, what you do is you say it over and over again to the point where like, all right, goddamn, I'm tired of hearing this shit.
Well, you know, if anything, I know what him and I got at this meeting, and I hope we got a lot more. You know, we can see more towards the future, you know, about things that we need to do and things that we shouldn't be allowing to happen. But, you know, what I would ask of you is, and obviously you're not going to bring this up because, you know, we're not going to talk about meeting or whatever, but that when you guys talk and, you know, whether he's drinking or whatever, you know, you truly, same way, you've heard everything. This little meeting here was not made up. He walked in my office, he called you, and what came out of here is true feelings from my heart for him. And I hope that you find the time to sit down sometime and say, you know what? You got it made with them two motherfuckers.
I tell them all the time.
They love you more than you know. And not about any particular issue. I said, even if you gotta, you know, you gotta go out of way, say, I wish I had somebody like that. You did the right, you made the right decision by surrounding yourself with somebody.
But what you don't understand is when I tell him those kinds of things that you guys are underappreciated or something, he gets mad at me
not
because I'm
no,
because
not about us, about him.
Yes,
no,
but
watch.
He gets mad at me for talking to you guys about him, mm-hmm. And
yeah.
That's the issue.
Like right
so
now,
I can't say anything to him about having a conversation with you.
Every time she brings up, this is where you understand this. We see a lot of Spanish people like this. He is very insecure. Even with us, brother. Like, he's told her not to come to my office. Knowing damn well they're never, you know, it's not even like that, you know? But I think people who've been naturally through the stuff he's done, and in some, in the guilty conscience, they worry that, and they start trying to control people. And that's where she's at right now, where even he trusts us with his life,
He would dare not want her to be associated with us. Isn't that weird? But that's how it is.
Yeah. Oh, but I mean, that could be the man in him.
Yeah, jealous. But come on.
Jealous. Right, but that's where I run into an issue. If I try to say, oh, well, Navarro, whatever, about you, about Ruben, if I'm just trying to talk to you, then it gets all, then he jumps on me. Oh, what, you were talking to them? What, why were you talking to them about
yeah.
me?
Yeah. See, that's why I know we can't fucking do an intervention.
So even if you try to say something, man, then two motherfuckers love you. Damn, some bitches love you.
But he doesn't seem like that.
All they ever do is talk. Whenever I'm around, you know, in general, they speak very positive of you. How much they, you know, they...
That doesn't matter. Yeah. It's
trust me, she's
done. Don't what I'm told. Don't talk to them about anything but work.
Yeah. I'm telling you, brother.
So.